Hi everyone, Aaron here for Zolotech, and I wanted to show you Wondershare Video Converter. This is the Ultimate Edition. It's available for both Mac and PC, and a lot of you have asked me, how do you convert different files or even download them from different sites, things like that, and this program will allow you to do that. Now, I've partnered with Wondershare to sponsor this video, and this particular program will be linked in the description below. Now, as you can see here, we have some options across the top. We have Convert, Download, Burn, Transfer, and Toolbox. So let's take a look at Convert, and I'll add a file. Now you want to make sure that you own these files or you have permission to use them, of course. And here's a video I made about cleaning AirPods, and you can add multiple videos at once if you want to convert them. So let me add another one here. And these are the input files, and this is the output file. So here you can see their MOV files. Here's the length, the file size, and the resolution that they're in. And you'll see here we have the target that we're changing it to, or we could convert it to anything we'd like. So you've got a bunch of different things you can convert to. If I click this button here, you'll see all the file formats. You can also get to this same place here by clicking this down arrow. So if you open this up, you'll see there are a ton of different file types. In fact, I don't think there's any that I wouldn't want, or wouldn't be able to find, rather. So you'll see we have everything from FLV, Vimeo, MP4, MOV, MKV, or we can export just the audio or adjust it even for things like Ogg Vorbis or FLAC lossless encodec or lossless quality codecs. And then we also have different devices that we can export to specifically, even Huawei devices or HTC and Samsung. If you want to export to something specifically for a specific resolution for a device, this has it there. So it's pretty impressive that way. And it will also look at the different editing codecs on your device. So you have everything from Final Cut, or if you're using Premiere, you'll have those available. And it's pretty nice and very thorough as far as what's available. Now you can change the audio format here. You've got your subtitle additions if you want to add subtitles. You've got different information you can change here as well as far as metadata, and then we can edit it or change the file sizes, things like that. Now over here we can trim the clip, so maybe we don't want the clip to be as long, or we want to split it into two clips, we can do that. And then also you've got some adjustments here as well. You can enhance it, change what it looks like, and you have real-time adjustments so you can see what it looks like. So it's pretty nice. Change the contrast if you want, saturation, or whatever you'd like to do with it, you can do. You can also watermark it. So if you, like I do here often, I watermark all my videos, you can watermark them, again, add subtitles and change the audio volume. So we'll cancel that. And let's take a look at the other options. So we have the option to download different files. Now, again, you want to make sure that you have permission or that you're on a website that you own and you want to download these if you lost access to it or something like that. We have high-speed download here. We also can record a video, but if we want to paste a URL, we can do that and pull the video in and download it that way. We also can burn a DVD if you have a DVD burner, or pull files off of a DVD, and then we can transfer as well. So it says connecting to your device. I have my iPhone plugged in. You'll see it sees it up here in the upper right. So you'll see it found my phone that's plugged in. It says two ways to transfer files, and you can add files to it. So maybe I want this one. We'll load, and then I can transfer it to my phone. So where it's kind of difficult to transfer different files to different devices on iPhones and things like that, this will allow you to do that pretty simply and go the other direction as well. And then probably my favorite thing here is the toolbox. You can fix media metadata, you can compress the video, you can cast your video to a TV. So if you have a different television available for casting, this says no device found, but let's see if we can find anything. I don't have any. Let's see if I have a file I can cast to a television. You'll see here. And you can add any of your different favorite cast or Chromecast devices. Now, again, we have more assistant tools such as a screen recorder, like I'm recording now. You have a GIF or GIF maker, or a DVD copy tool. So maybe you want to make a GIF or GIF out of whatever file. Click OK. Let's go to a file here. And if I want to make a GIF or GIF here, I say GIF, you may say GIF, either way, I believe it's GIF. So you can change the duration, and then you can just create one from this. We'll just save it to the desktop here. We'll create it right now. It'll pull that out of the file and it will create the file. So let me open it. You'll see it created it for me so I could share that to social media. So it has a lot of really great features that are simple and straightforward. This is so easy to use and I think will benefit a lot of people. If you're trying to convert a lot of things, maybe you want to merge multiple videos into one or cast them to a different device. And then you have a couple different options down here as well. If we click on this, when a task is complete, you can shut it down, sleep, do nothing. And then you've got high speed conversion. And it really is quite fast because it will use not only software, but it can use any available hardware as well. So we'll turn that on. And then maybe we want to convert this or convert in a batch. We can do that and it will start to convert. And these are fairly large videos, so they will take a while, but it says 4.2 minutes left, 5.6 minutes left, which is actually quite fast to convert something that's over 5 minutes long. And it's converting both of them at the same time. So that's pretty impressive and definitely something I can recommend. It's simple and straightforward. And if you'd like to try it for yourself, you can open up a web browser here. And as you can see, it's available for not only Mac, but it's available for Windows. If you go to this website, I'll leave a link to it in the description, but you can try it free or you can buy it if it's something that you want to use regularly. You have a lifetime license for $60 or so, and this could vary if there's coupon codes and things like that. Again, you have the Windows version here. So let me know what you think about it in the comments below. Is it something you would use to convert different files and things like that? I think this is a very impressive time to convert both of these at the same time. So that part's pretty impressive to me. But let me know what you think in the comments below. If you haven't subscribed already, please subscribe and like. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.